The Lord. Today is Wednesday. This is our midweek service, and we want to thank the Lord for the faithfulness of all of you Christians, St. Luke, who have been faithfully attending all our services, our fellowships, and continually being focused and interested in the ministries that are conducted and followed here at our church. So I am pleased that today I'm sharing with you, following another series of sermons and addresses that have been made in relation to leadership, especially Christian leadership following the Jesus model. And this evening I'm sharing with you about the characteristics of leadership, of a good leader, and the leadership of a Christian who is following Jesus Christ. So let us pray. Father, we in heaven, we want to thank you for this opportunity you have given us to be together as your children. Wherever we have assembled, whether in the homes, whether in office, whether seated in a car, there is your church. So Father, we thank you and we bless your name, that you give us the opportunity to listen to you and to learn from you, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. So we are talking about attributes of a good leadership. Attributes or characteristics of good leadership. And as you know, in the understanding of the word good itself is relative. It depends on who is saying or calling it good. So when we say good leadership, it depends on from what perspective one is talking about a good leader or good leadership, because good is in itself is relative. So from our own interest, because we are talking as Christians, we are talking about a Christian leader. So we are talking about attributes of good Christian leadership. And these are very, very important for us as Christians who have modeled our leadership after Christ himself. So what are these qualities or characteristics of good Christian leadership? That's what we want to look at. The Bible is very, very, very clear. When you go to the book of 1 Peter chapter 5, he talks about leadership, what type of leadership we should go or be. And when you go even chapter 4, verse 10, he talks of a leader with a servant heart. You know, that is the leadership we are talking about. But we want to identify seven things that make that qualify one to be practicing good Christian leadership. And these are very, very important, and Jesus used them. One is the most and the top of all what we talk about Christian leadership is integrity. Integrity is the key. Integrity is the key. When you read, the letter of Paul to Timothy chapter 3, verse 8 to 12. He gives qualification of a person who is above reproach, a person who has been tested, a person who is himself or herself in the day, in light, or in darkness. Wherever you are the same. What you say your yes is yes, your no is no. So you are best on the Christian principle, and that is integrity. Integrity, that you are transparent and you are able to pass out anything out of your mouth is not twisted at all, because you know what you are talking about. So the first characteristic of a good Christian leader or leadership is integrity. Do we carry our integrity in leadership? Integrity is the key. The second is ability to delegate. Jesus was so good at that. Even he would call upon his, you know, Peter or John and say, let's go together. So they learn from him and he's able to hand over. He's ready to hand over to them. So that is a very, very important good leadership characteristic in leadership, the Jesus model. The third one is ability to communicate. Communication is a very, very important characteristic. Communicating, being able to pass out, you know, proclaim what you've received or you want to be taken on seriously. So communication is very key. And the fourth is self-awareness. And this goes in line with integrity, self-awareness. Jesus knew himself, knew he was from God. Whatever he was doing, he must be based on what he has learned from the Father. So we must know ourselves, if we are to do good leadership, we must know ourselves. What is your strength? What is your weakness? What are you able to do and you are not able to do? And therefore, how knowledgeable are you in order to do what you are supposed to do? That is very important in the leadership. If it must be that which is God, you know, given leadership and based on God's model. And the fifth one is gratitude. We must build a heart of gratitude. Jesus was always, you know, able to show he was, you know, gratified with what was going on. He would always want to appreciate, you know, his disciples, those who were following him. So any leader who does not appreciate, who doesn't have a heart of leadership, is missing very, very important ingredient of Christian leadership. And then another one, the seventh, is the learning ability. And a learning ability. And you can only get this from prayer, from, you know, retreating yourself in order to empower yourself again and again. So that is a very important characteristic. Do you have the ability to learn? There are many of us who are not, you know, don't have that ability. And you learn from others. You learn from what you have read. You learn from what you have encountered. So that your ability, you are able to step aside of yourself and learn from others. That is a very, very important characteristic. And another one, which is the ace, is influence. It's a great characteristic. A leader influences other people. You know, what comes of you, out of you, is able to, like, you know, enter into other people, and they are influenced to do the right thing. I remember when I was in school, in primary, I used that, you know, to put my collar, you know, up sometimes, you know, kind of following what the teacher was doing. I would want to look like my teacher. So that was something that was influencing me. I would want to hear how the teacher has pronounced a word, and I also want to do it the same way. You see, so you do the imitation, but in doing that, you are being influenced to do the right thing. So influencing as a leader is a very great characteristic, to know that your leadership is going to influence others. And look at yourself as a Christian. If you are born again, if you know Christ, if you really live within you, you know that you have a testimony. You would want that to influence others. What has made what you are, you want other people to have it. That is the influence I am emphasizing. And God, Jesus did that so well that he wanted to influence. And he was always, even one time he sent them two by two, saying, go and see what happens. Go and do this. Pray for the people. So when they went, practicing what they had learned from him, that was a sign of having been influenced by his example. So the last important, you know, important characteristic of any good Christian leader is empathy. You know, a good Christian leader must have that characteristic. You know, are you able, at whatever level, whatever comes out of you, whatever you want to pass on, whatever influence you want to make,
Are you putting yourself in the shoes of those people that you are leading, in the shoes of your organization? If you are a church leader, whatever you want to do, are you putting yourself in the shoes of the Christian who is going to listen to it, who is going to learn from you and learn of it? So empathy, it can be at the level of people who are, you know, weak, who you need to, you know, put yourself in their shoes. But at all level, high or low or middle, you must have the empathy. You know, put yourself in the shoes of what you are doing. If this was done to me, how would I feel? If I am the one who received it this way, how would that feel? So that is a great characteristic of good Christian leadership. So brethren, wherever you are, test yourself in these characteristics and see. And we are talking of Christian leadership, taking the Jesus model. And Jesus taught us that we cannot be good leaders. We cannot have anything called good leadership unless we take the servant leadership model. Are we able to serve, or we want to be served? You see, and scripture, you know, the Bible provides the greatest opportunity for us, because it encourages us to always be connected to the source of the leadership, to the source of the characteristics of everything, and that is God. God gives us the opportunity to serve. So because we are not serving from our own liking, we are serving on behalf of God. So any leader, brethren, any leader at any level, even at in your home, you know, or even if you are a firstborn and other children have come after you, you are a leader in a way. Even if you are in a shop, even if you are at a place of work, any leadership which is Christian, and it must be called good based on the Christian principles. One must have the following principles, which are connected to the characteristics. One, a leader must listen to his followers. You must be that leader who is able to listen to your followers in order to lead well. Second, a leader must focus on the people you are leading. Okay? You focus on the leader, on the purpose you are leading. The back is facing is somewhere, but for you, you are focusing on those you are leading, because you don't want them to be lost. And that's what Jesus was doing. He was focusing on the people he was leading. The best leader, you know, humbles himself and is able he takes the credit for the success of the all. So you look for a success and you take the credit. It's not yours, it's the credit of the whole organization. So you are focused. You look for harmony in what you are doing. And another third point, which is very, very crucial, a good Christian leader, you know, promoting characteristics of good leadership, is that one who emphasizes we, not me. Whatever you are doing, at whatever level, if you are servant leader, it is we have done this. We are able to do this. We Christians of this church, not me, the clergy, not me, the head of Leite. No, it is we, because you are doing it together to achieve. And it is only servant leadership that helps us to go to this level. Because we work as a team, so success is accomplished by all of us. You don't strive on your own, because you are mission oriented. You have a mission strategy, you have what you want to achieve, and therefore God helps you to do it in that way. And you are emphasizing that kind of leadership. So, brethren, as we come closer to, you know, clearly understanding a good leadership which is Christian based, which is servant leadership, Allow me to bring out other 10 characteristics of a very good strategic leader. And we are all called to be leaders. One, strong, he must be very, very well good connected in communication. Secondly, a good listener. Thirdly, must have compassion and commitment. Fourthly, he must have what we call positivity. He or she must be positive in all what you do. Be positive, so that you can do work in a hard way and you are able to serve whatever situation. And fifthly, innovation. You must be innovative in the way you do things. Don't mark time. There are leaders who mark time. Yeah? There are leaders even at a family level, at whatever level, who are just in one place. They never move. That means they do not plan ahead. They don't strategically look to the future. So be innovative. And sixthly, genuine collaboration. Collaborate. Relate with each other. We are one another's keeper. You cannot be an island of yourself. You must work with others. So we need genuine collaboration. There are people who do collaboration, but at a fragile level. They don't want to be transparent. They always see as if they are collaborating, but in a way, they are reserving. And this is done politically most of the time in government and other organizations. If he leaves the chair, he leaves with all the authority and he locks the stamps and everything. There are things someone doesn't want to be shown or known. So, and if you want to collaborate with other people, you must be transparent and you belong and you know that there is nothing you hide. You do things as if you will not be there tomorrow in the next hour because someone else you have been collaborating with can easily say, this is the way things were always done here. So that's very, very crucial in showing that you are a good leader. Then seventhly, really to be honest. Honesty is the greatest characteristic of a good leader. Honesty. There is no leadership that does not hold honesty very important. Call a spade, say things properly. If that's what you mean, say it. Even in a pulpit like me preaching, if I am saying this, I say it and that's what I mean. I don't see one thing and leave another differently. No, that will be disproved later. Even political level, we are now shouting everywhere looking for votes politically. People are going to promise heaven and earth. When they are not actually going to do that, is there any honesty? Honesty is very important. Eighthly, diplomacy. Hold things diplomatically. Don't mix things. If you are talking with your children, use the diplomacy that fits them. And when you are talking to your wife, when you are talking to your subordinates in office, when you are talking to your boss, use diplomacy. Diplomacy is very, very important, and you be tactful in the way you help. Because it will help you to manage conflicts and be able to negotiate at any level, wherever. So, number nine, as I mentioned earlier, empathy. Always put yourself in the shoes of others. Remember, what comes out of you as a leader, you should ask yourself, as it is stated in Matthew 7:12, that what you want to do, things done for you, must do it for others. You see, that is the best Christian principle. So, it is at the heart of empathy. And finally, humility. Letter of Peter, chapter 5, it says, chapter 5, verse 6, says, humble yourself under the mighty hand of God. In due time, you will be uplifted. So any good Christian leadership must have that at heart. Humble yourself. Jesus was so humble that, he stooped down. He was so low that he was even able to wash the disciples' feet so that he is a servant leader. How many of us really go to that level? So our challenge as we talk about the characteristics of good Christian leadership is exactly that we must not focus on positions to be filled in organization, but focus on people, focus on people and humble ourselves so that we relate so well with those that we are leading. So those are the major characteristics of good Christian leadership. So, but finally, let's go to the Bible. What does the Bible teach? Because ours is biblical, we have to base all our leadership principles, our leadership must emanate from the Bible. Number one, the Bible talks of intimate relationship with God. We cannot have anything called good characteristic of Christian leadership unless it is based on intimate relationship with God. Is the power source. We must be connected with God. That's number one. Jesus was connected with his Father. When you read Mark chapter 1 verse 35 and 6 verse 35, for example, he always retreated and sought connection with his Father. He went into prayer. Number two, servant must have a servant heart. We must have a servant heart so that when we are, wherever we are we actually serving or we want to be served? Do we know where we get our power to do what we are doing? That means that we're connected with God. 1 Peter chapter 4 verse 10 will give you that. Peter says, we know all our power comes from above. So, number three, we must have a shepherd heart. We are shepherding God's people. We are doing something on behalf of our master. So, God is the chief shepherd. So, we have been given responsibility to shepherd. Even at a family level, the father, the mother, whoever, you are a shepherd. You have given the responsibility. But the children and the estate and all what is not yours, it is God's. Even in office, even at the level of a nation or a ministry, we are shepherds. Number four, we must live with character and integrity. Live with. Live with. Not just in the home or in office. Live with it wherever you are, even when playing, going somewhere, whether in a meeting, do you live with character and integrity? You see? So, unless you have that character that brings out the integrity, that's what 1 Timothy 3:8-12 talks about. And Titus chapter 1, verse 9 talks about character and integrity. One time I remembered on a plane traveling with some big person who is a church leader. And when we're on a plane, in the plane they come, serving everything. And I saw this person ordered a whiskey. I saw a bottle which I didn't understand. I was seated, in the next seat. He was behind me. But I looked back and I saw, a bottle of whiskey, put on his table. And I couldn't believe. You see? So, but by the time we went out, came out of the plane and I tried to greet him, the man was speaking so, powerfully. It seems he was not himself. He had already taken the whole bottle, I think, of wine, of that whatever called wine was a whiskey. So you can see the integrity. Back home here, he's a powerful person. When he goes in the pulpit, you can't believe. But on the plane, when he's flying to Canada, where we were going, he was another person. You see? So what happens when he didn't know that I saw him? But it's when that is character and integrity. And number five, which is the final one I want to emphasize, is please, at whatever level, as a leader, be committed to making disciples. Consciously or unconsciously. You may not know, but whatever you are doing, make sure you know that you are making disciples. There are people who are following you. So wherever you are making disciples. This is what Jesus was committed to when he gave us the Great Commission, chapter 28 of Matthew. He said, go into the world and make disciples. So we are making disciples consciously or unconsciously. How I wish we could do it consciously. But know that there is also what we call hidden curriculum. There are things that are in you which you do, you know, and you may not know that you are influencing other people. You see, if you are good at telling lies, you may not know that you are influencing your children or the people you work with. You know, if you call your subordinate to change a figure in office and add some other figure, you may think you have passed that, but you have done, you have given a hidden curriculum to this person. You are making a terrible disciple. So, my brethren, I want to conclude by emphasizing that really a good Christian leader must be aware that whatever you do, do it for God. A Christian leader aims at equipping emerging leaders, emerging those who are following you, who will continue the mission after you are no longer there. You know, change is inevitable. So you should know, Jesus knew that when he is no longer there, his disciples will continue. So that is a greater characteristic. Know that in whatever you do, you are duplicating, you are really making disciples. There are people who are going to follow what you are doing. That's what teachers do. That's what preachers, disciples do. And what leaders at any level, good ones, good in the real sense of Christian servant leadership, is that you are serving now so that those around you will also serve even better than you have served. May God help you at your level, family, or wherever you are to serve. Know that you are serving and by empowering others. God help you. Jesus did it. God did it. He chose great leaders and leaders. David was after God's own heart. We know Moses. He left, you know. We know Elisha. And many other leaders did that. Joseph did it. But we need humility. We need integrity. And we know that what we are passing on will live even beyond our time. And you know that you are not there today. If you are no longer there, what will people say? You know, when you are no longer there, how will people know that you were there? And what will they say? So may the Lord help us to know what we pass on. Praise the Lord, and let's humble ourselves and pray and ask for God's guidance in creating a heart of integrity, a heart of humility, and a heart of servanthood. Father, we thank you for speaking to us. Thank you for teaching us how to pass on, how to be conscious of the power base. You are the source of all power. Integrity, humility, servant leadership is only from you. We learn from you, and we pray that whatever we learn of you and in you and through you, we are able to pass it on, consciously or unconsciously. Guide us, Lord. But we can never do all this unless we accept you as our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, because you are our great example. We cannot do whatever we do unless we have an encounter with you. So, Jesus, help us. Those who are listening to me, wherever you are, please think about this. Turn your heart to Christ, and everything will go according to his own guidance. In the name of God the Father, of the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Amen.